Hey, how's it going? So we're kicking down here in San Diego. We got down here from Joshua Tree just the other day. I actually went and hung out with my sister. She's back from India and living in New York, but she came down to visit my parents. So I went down there and we went and had a nice lunch yesterday and hung out, and then came down here to San Diego to a friend of mine I have known for over 30 some years. I went to high school with them, boarding school, Harper's. And he's friends with Greg. In one of my earlier videos, Greg was at the same boarding school up there in Maine, and that's where we all met. But I haven't seen him since 2008, and his son even was only 2 years old. So I got to see Grayson again, and he's 16. It was pretty cool. We went and had lunch yesterday. We're gonna go grab some breakfast burritos, but we're just hanging out here. It's a total bachelor pad, pretty amazing little space, pool. The inside is a man's world, baskets of swords, all sorts of cool stuff. But look at this view of Mission Bay, San Diego, downtown San Diego, those hills way over there, that's Mexico. That's where we're gonna be probably heading here, I think is the plan. We're gonna spend a couple days down here. Harps has been real cordial to let us stay here because we gotta get little Winagi over here. She's gotta go and we're gonna get her vaccine. We gotta get her chipped, like an electronic chip under her skin for tracking her, and then get her all her rabies and all her health documents ready so that we can go to a foreign country and apply for residency visas wherever we go. But I think the plan is going to be taking that rig and going down Baja, Mexico, at least for a little bit. That's kind of tentative. Haven't pulled the trigger yet on it, obviously. But I've spent some time down in Baja, Mexico in the past on Enduro that I owned when I fought fire in the winters. I used to take that down there. But we'll bring you along for the journey, whatever we end up doing. But just wanted to share this like amazing view. Look at this. I mean, this is why you pay for the places down here in San Diego. It's just epic, you know. And when I was younger, in my teens and my 20s, I used to hang down here with Harps, and it's an amazing place. And it's really still just that. The weather is just amazing. You can see the sun's out. It's I'm in shorts, t-shirt, and it's just amazing. And look at little Winagi. She's just sunning on the deck here, hanging out. But anyways, yeah, I just wanted to update you on what's going on. We're kind of bopping around the video here. We were in Joshua Tree, and then Palm Springs, which is just outside of Joshua Tree. And I've just been kind of popping through, visiting friends and saying hello and catching up, because, you know, if we do end up bailing to another country, I may not see these people again, at least not for a long time, unless they come down to visit, which would be awesome. But reality is everyone's got their lives, and just like not seeing Harper for so many years, it just happens that way. But that's why we're catching up with people, because people, friends is important, and especially Harper's family. He's like a brother, just like Greg was, and some of my other friends, Joel up in LA. I didn't film any of that, but Joel Fitzpatrick, good friend of mine too. Love that guy. He was from another boarding school. So anyways, thanks for joining us. If you're new to my channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button, the little bell right there. Give that a slap, and leave us any comments down below, because again, Winagi likes to hear from you, right? Hey, dog park. That's the only way I can get her to pay attention. Anyways, right on. Catch you later, Reds. This song goes out to my friend Eric. I'm gonna fucking miss you, brother. My best fucking friend from when I was in fucking high school and on. Fucking amazing guy. I shared so much with him. He just passed away a couple days ago. And I'm gonna fucking miss you, Eric. You are fucking stellar. You're fucking here in my heart. I know I'll see you again some fucking day, bro. I fucking love you. I hope you didn't suffer, and I hope you went fast, man. I fucking love you, bro. I fucking love you. This one's for you. Fuck. fucking EY. Yellin. Fucking Yellin, man. Fuck yeah, bro. You know I miss you. I fucking know I'll see you again. Fucking sucks when you lose friends, man. It fucking sucks. I know he went to a better place and his energy's fucking still here and still there and still part of me and I get all that, but when the fucking vessel goes, man, it fucking sucks because there's no more fucking time together here. But you're fucking lost, you are. You're everywhere now, bro. We shared some fucking times, bro. Boston University fucking campus. Running around Boston at fucking 2 in the morning. Fucking chasing rats and bricks. Fuck, dude. Holy shit, it's out there somewhere. Fuck. Brother, I fucking miss you, brother. I fucking miss you. Love you, EY. I fucking love you, bro. Right on, bro. I fucking love you, bro. I'll see you again someday. Not in physical. I love you, brother. I love you. Arizona. It's a metal detecting club, and I've got a metal detector. I've done it up in Idaho and stuff, and it's just kind of a fun hobby to do. Sometimes you find some cool historic stuff. I found a few pieces of jewelry, silver coins, things like that along the ways. Some amalgamated gold, little gold nugget kind of stuff, nothing big. But we were up here, this whole area here is the claim. And then if you look down this way, way off in the distance, those rolling hills, Quartzrite's way down there, the town, and then pretty much it's surrounded by BLM land. All this is basically BLM land, and so it's camping for 14 days, and then you just got to move and stuff. But that's what people do, retirees and the likes. They come here and spend their winters here. Moving around. There's a bunch of different places, but Quartzrite's one of the more famous places. They have a huge RV gathering here. And then down in Quartzrite, which has already started, it's pretty much all winter long, they have several events. And one of the biggest rock and gem shows in the world is here. And then, you know, they're selling everything down in town. And we'll probably head down towards town here in a little bit. We didn't have much luck today. Got outside, got to dig, and that was fun. Just hanging out. She's tuckered out, but Auggie's over here crashed out. You can see her. She just, we've been running around all morning up here. We got up pretty early and she's just enjoying the sun and relaxing in the sunshine. And here's our truck. If you haven't seen our truck, I think you did in an earlier video, but we bought this 4x4 F4 250. We had bought a Ram, Hemi Ram 2014. It was awesome, but they sold me on the payload and it was a lie. So I took it back to the dealership. I ended up writing a scathing review and they actually called me back and said, we'll do anything if you take the review down. So they gave me back my money. And then I got kind of pressured into buying a Yukon GMC. I was just trying to get anything because I was in a bad situation. I needed to get away from what I was in. It just wasn't a cool situation. I won't go into that, but so I bought this GMC and without doing due diligence on it, it ended up with a worn out engine and it drove great, but it was just a matter of time before that engine was gonna go and it wasn't worth the risk. So I got this guy, my father helped me. We just one day, I put a bed back in here. It's like 3 inches of memory foam. And I got a big pad and a bunch of sleeping bags. And so it's great sleeping. And then you see, I put this silver stuff in the windows so it stays reflective, nice and cool in there. And then also it's kind of stealth. And then Winagi's got this whole big bed. It's got memory foam, a down comforter, and then this blanket I can shake out every day from her hair. But she's got a nice big bed, and then she can crawl through there if she wants to into the back here. But yeah, here's the metal detector. It's charging right now. You can see it, and then I charge the headphones too are in there, and I'm charging both things. But yeah, that's all. It's luxury here. Look, we got a nice little blue box to go to the bathroom in. Winagi's got her little toys. We always get her lots of toys. But that's all we got going, folks. When Augie's up, she heard the speaker. You ready to go into town there, kiddo? And that's probably what we're gonna do, head into town here shortly. But again, yeah, we're in Arizona. We're gonna spend probably a couple weeks here, moving around, maybe go to Lake Havasu before we go into Baja, Mexico, I think's the plan, or mainland Mexico for a couple months until the Philippines opens up or until this COVID thing's kind of run its course. But yeah. That's the plan. Kind of waiting on the title on this truck, and that way we can get into Mexico. We can go down into Baja. We don't need the title, but to get into mainland Mexico, I need the title. So my friend up in Portland's gonna send it to me as soon as it gets in, hopefully in the next 2 or 3 weeks at most, hopefully 2 weeks. I don't really want to wait a freaking month for it, but it's been about 3 weeks now, so hopefully it'll come soon. But we'll show you when we go down to that Rock and Gem show. There's a couple things. It isn't the main show yet, but there's a couple things to check out, which is pretty cool. So we'll have you come join us,
buddy. That sun feels good, huh, Waggy?
Hey, if you're new to our channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button and then the little bell next to it. It'll let you know of future videos, live events, things like that. It's kind of like a calendar marker, and it'll just give you a dinger when something's coming up, something new has been posted. And I post videos every Friday, yeah, that's about it. Leave comments down below. Winagi loves to hear your comments, but she's just enjoying this afternoon, and like I said, we're going to be heading down to Quartz right here shortly. It's the town down here in Arizona that we pulled into and we're camping by, lots of BLM land. But we're going to go check out the gem and minerals they got down there. It's like a huge, basically a huge swap meet through the whole town. All the different open lots have massive amounts of people selling stuff. So it's just kind of fun to go look around, and that's what we're going to do. So we went to the store and we got the essentials. Milk duds for dessert. Tapatio, because we're going to have chili mac, or maybe potatoes and chili, I'm not sure yet. And then Canada Dry Club soda, because I got ice, and it's just nice at the end of a day having a club soda. I don't drink liquor, so. Its effervescence is very enjoyable. Hey, got a little monkey splotch on the camera there. Anyways, Winagi's playing ball. Hey, bring your ball here. Yeah. She's not so much. See, she's just hanging out. Hey, give me your ball. What are you doing? Are you having fun? Yeah. Here's our view, mountains here. You can see there's RVs all out in the distance. This whole desert, I mean, way over there, there's a huge RV village out there. They say the town's like probably 3,000 or 4,000 people, but in winter time, it goes to like 30 or 40,000. Because all the RVers and retirees come down here to metal detect and hang out and just enjoy the desert. I mean, last night I was in like the higher 40s to 50s. Again, tonight's gonna be like 45 to 50 degrees at night. And then, which is nothing. And then during the days, it's like 65, maybe 70 at most. It's like the perfect weather. It's desert, so it's dusty, but other than that, it's pretty nice. So anyways, I'm gonna put on my hoodie because it is getting cooler, and then I'm gonna start making dinner. Start rocking the din-din.